Now, since we do not need this testnet anymore, so we can delete the Ethereum 2 chain only, because Ethereum 1 chain will be the same for every testnet, as in Medela testnet, and is also same in the Pyramon testnet. Since we need to create new validators again, so we have to delete the Ethereum 2 chain for the next testnet. In Medela testnet, I kept the Ethereum 1 chain and deleted the Ethereum 2 chain for the new testnet, Pyramon testnet, to get synchronized and create new validators. So for the coming testnet based on tokenomics, so we need to remove the Ethereum 2 chain. So I will do that with this command, docker volume ls. So we will just delete the docker of the Ethereum 2 chain. Okay, first we will stop the chain. So here from this command, look, if we terminate, it will delete everything, Ethereum 1 and Ethereum 2 chain both. So we are not going to terminate it, so we will just stop it. Rocket pool service stop. Okay, it's done. It is stopped. Now we will delete. We will type docker volume ls and delete the, remove the Ethereum 2 chain. So we will remove the Ethereum 2 client data. So remove. Can't remove. So we will try this docker volume remove, this command. I think this one will work. Okay, volume is in use. So we'll try this Docker remove rocket pull. Yeah, I think it's done. Then Docker volume remove this one. Yeah, it's done. So we are, yeah, it's clean now. So this over here, stop the rocket pool service and clear your Medela. When I last time I used this to clean the Medela testnet data, Ethereum 2 data, both chain and client data for the Paramount testnet. So these CLI commands are same for the every testnet and even on the mainnet. So this is working. These CLI commands are working. So what we have to do first, rocket pool stop, rocket pool service stop, then Docker remove rocket pool underscore Ethereum 2 and Docker remove this. Now few more things. If you want to delete the configuration, you need to delete all these things for the next upcoming testnet. So we will remove this folder also, dot rocket pool, and that rocket pool node, client node that we installed. So this folder dot rocket pool contains your wallet validator, Ethereum chain data. So we will remove this. Done. So if you do ls, okay, ls minus al minus al, you won't find that dot rocket pool folder. Backup folder is still there, so we can delete with simply with remove, then this backup this dot this will also do this. Okay, we have to put sudo. This way also you can remove the files and folder. Okay, we have to delete it recursively, so we try with minus r. Okay, sudo remove minus r, then dot rocket pool dot back. Yeah, ls minus al. Now you see it's clean. Now that on that bean folder, that rocket pool node, this thing. This. रॉकेट पुल स्मार्ट नोड क्लाइंट। दिस थिंग रॉकेट पुल व्हेन ही फर्स्ट इंस्टॉल्ड इट, या दिस इज रॉकेट पुल स्मार्ट नोड पैकेज, इट कंटेन्स एवरीथिंग, सो इट्स इन द बीन फोल्डर एंड हाउ टू इंस्टॉल एंड प्रोसीड इट्स गिवन ऑन द ऑफिशियल डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, सो वी विल रिमूव दिस ऑल्सो। आइदर यू कैन रिमूव इट बाई गोइंग इन टू दैट फोल्डर एंड यूज रिमूव आर एम that folder, that file name, or if it's a directory then recursively you have to delete, remove minus R then that directory name, or you can just this way also directly from without going into that directory, you can also remove with this command. So it's also done. You just go and see in the bean folder, nothing is there. Yeah, it's done. Everything is clean. Now I'm ready for the next upcoming testnet for tokenomics. So see you soon. Bye.